In last class we studied about transpose of a matrix. In this class we will study about symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. Let capital A be a square matrix of order, say M. Now, this square matrix A is said to be a symmetric matrix. The condition required is A transpose is equal to A. If A transpose equal to A, then matrix A is said to be a symmetric matrix. In this case, the element Aji must be equal to element Aij. For example, matrix A equal to, matrix must be a square matrix. 1, 2, 2, 3. See here, Aji must be equal to Aij. So here, the element A12 is 2, which is also equal to the element A21. So the condition will be satisfied. So this matrix is called as a symmetric matrix. We can check that. That is, you have to find A transpose. So transpose of a matrix, you have to interchange the rows and columns. So first row becomes the first column of transpose, and second row becomes the second column of the transpose. Now see, both A and A dash are same. So A dash equal to A implies A is a symmetric matrix. Another example. 1, 2, 3. If A12 is 2, then A21 must be 2. Now A13 is 3, so A31 must be 3. Then A23 is minus 4, so A32 is also minus 4. And there is no condition for diagonal element. So this is an example of a symmetric matrix of order 3 cross 3. We will check the condition, that is B dash. You have to interchange the rows and columns. So first you have to write the first row as first column, that is 1, 2, 3 is the first column of B transpose. Now second row to second column and third row to third column. Now both B dash and B are same. Therefore, it is an example for a symmetric matrix. So the condition required is A transpose equal to A. Now, if A transpose is equal to minus A, A is a square matrix with the condition A transpose is equal to minus A, then matrix A is called as a skew symmetric matrix. See, here the condition is Aji is equal to minus Aij for every I, j. That is, suppose if I consider the element A21, then A21 must be equal to minus A12. In the same condition, if I take I equal to j, so that is in the place of j, if I substitute I, then it becomes Aii is equal to minus Aii. If I take this minus to this, 2 Aii equal to 0, that implies ai equal to 0 for every I. So ai means it is a diagonal element. So in a skew symmetric matrix, all the diagonal elements are 0. And the condition for non-diagonal element is aj I equal to minus aij. So a square matrix A is said to be a skew symmetric matrix if A transpose is equal to minus A, and one more condition is all the diagonal elements must be equal to 0. Now we will write one example. Okay. I will write 1, 2 cross 2 matrix. The condition for diagonal elements all are 0. If I write the element A12 as 2, then A21 must be negative of A12. Now we will find A transpose. That is, first row of A is the first column of A dash, and second row becomes the second column. If I take minus to the outside, throughout minus 1 to outside, 0 as it is, minus 2 becomes plus 2, 2 becomes minus 2, and 0 is 0 itself. Now this is same as matrix A, so this is minus A. So if A transpose is equal to minus A, then this matrix is called as a skew symmetric matrix. Write one more example. I will write one more. Take it, matrix B, 0, 1, minus 2. This is A12, it is plus 1. Then A21 must be negative of that, that is minus 1. 0, 3. Now here A13 is minus 2, so A31 must be negative of that, that is 2. And A23 is 3, so A32 must be negative, that is minus 3, and the diagonal element is 0. So it is a skew symmetric matrix of order 3. Just remember the condition: if A transpose is equal to A, then that matrix is called as a symmetric matrix, and if A transpose is equal to minus A, then that matrix is called as a skew symmetric matrix. Now we will prove one theorem. Theorem 1, the statement is, for any square matrix A, with the real entries A plus A dash is a symmetric matrix, and A minus A dash is a skew symmetric matrix. So the statement of the theorem is, for any square matrix A with the real entries A plus A dash is a symmetric matrix, and A minus A dash is a skew symmetric matrix. So we have to prove this, that is A plus A dash is symmetric, and also A minus A dash is a skew symmetric matrix. So given condition is, A A is a square matrix. First we have to prove A plus A dash is a symmetric matrix. I will consider A plus A dash is equal to a new matrix, that is matrix B. Since we have to prove A plus A dash is symmetric, it is enough to prove the matrix B is symmetric. So matrix B is symmetric implies it is enough to prove B dash is equal to B. So for that, now consider B transpose. Matrix B means it is A plus A dash whole transpose. Now this is of this form: A plus B whole dash is equal to A dash plus B dash. This property we already studied in the transpose of the matrix. Same condition we have kept here. So A plus B whole transpose is A transpose plus B transpose, that is A transpose whole transpose. Now which is equal to A transpose as it is. Again one more property in the transpose, that is A transpose whole transpose is equal to A. So in the place of A transpose whole transpose, we can write it as matrix A. Again in the operation or addition, here we have different addition. Matrix A plus B equal to B plus A, that is commutative property. By this we can write this as A plus A transpose. But actually what is A plus A transpose? It is matrix B. So here we got B transpose equal to B. The meaning of B transpose equal to B is B is a symmetric matrix. But what is B? B equal to A plus A dash. Therefore, from this we can write B is equal to A plus A dash is a symmetric matrix. First condition is already proved. Now we have to prove the second condition, that is A minus A dash is a skew symmetric matrix. So for that, consider A minus A dash is equal to a new matrix C. Here we have to prove A minus A dash is skew symmetric, or it is enough to prove C is skew symmetric. C is skew symmetric implies it is same that C transpose is equal to minus. Same procedure. So now we have to consider matrix C transpose. C means A minus A dash. So this is A minus A dash whole transpose. Again the property in transpose, that is A minus B whole transpose is equal to A transpose minus B transpose. So here it becomes A transpose minus A transpose whole transpose. Again we have A transpose whole transpose equal to A. So it becomes A transpose minus A. If I take minus outside or minus 1 outside, it becomes A minus A dash. But what is A minus A dash? It is matrix C. So it becomes minus C. So we get C dash is equal to minus C implies matrix C is skew symmetric. But what is matrix C? It is A minus A dash. Therefore, matrix C, that is A minus A dash, general, if A is a square matrix, then A plus A dash is always a symmetric matrix and A minus A dash is a skew symmetric matrix. So this is theorem. The statement is any square matrix can be expressed as the sum of a symmetric the sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. To prove this, let us consider a square matrix A. We can write A as half into A plus A dash plus half into A minus. On simplifying the right hand side, we again get A only, because half A plus half A equal to A, again half A dash minus half A dash, getting cancelled again we get A. So we can write a square matrix A as half into A plus A dash plus half into A minus A dash. Here A is a square matrix. Now see the theorem 1. So what is theorem 1 says? For any square matrix A, A plus A dash is a symmetric matrix and A minus A dash is skew symmetric. So by theorem 1, we have the condition A plus A dash is symmetric matrix and A minus A dash is skew symmetric matrix. So from theorem 1 we have A plus A dash is symmetric and A minus A dash is skew symmetric. And also we have one property in transpose of matrix, that is K into A whole transpose is equal to K into A transpose. This is the property in transpose of a matrix, that is K into A whole transpose equal to K into A transpose. By using theorem 1 and this condition, we can say that half into A plus A transpose is a symmetric matrix and half into A minus A dash a skew symmetric matrix. Therefore, from this we can say that any square matrix A can be written as sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. So, in the theorem 2, we are considering the theorem 1. And also the condition KA whole transpose equal to K into A transpose. So these two conditions lead us to the conditions that half into A plus A transpose is symmetric and half into A minus A transpose is skew symmetric. Hence the theorem 2 is First question. For the mantis, A is equal to 1, 5, 6, 7. Verify. First one, A plus A dash. Symmetric matrix and second one A minus A dash is a skew symmetric matrix. Now the solution. In order to check A plus A dash is symmetric, first you have to find A transpose. We have A is equal to matrix 1, 5, 6, 7. First we have to find A transpose. So transpose means you have to interchange the rows and columns. So first row of A becomes the first column of A transpose. And the second row becomes the second column. So A transpose is 1, 6, 5, 7. Now consider or let matrix B equal to A plus A transpose. So matrix A is 1, 5, 6, 7 plus matrix A transpose is 1, 6, 5, 7. Now we will add this. Here order is same and you have to add the corresponding element. So 1 plus 1, 2, 5 plus 6, 11, 6 plus 5, 11, and 7 plus 7, 14. So this is matrix B now. We have to verify A plus A dash is symmetric. That means we have to prove B transpose equal to B. So already we got matrix B. Now we will find B transpose. That is, first row becomes first column, second row becomes second column. Now check both B and B transpose. Both are same. So B transpose is equal to B implies matrix B is symmetric matrix. Therefore, B is symmetric. But what is B? B is A plus A dash. Now, the second question, that is A minus A dash is skew symmetric. For that, consider matrix C, which is A minus A dash. Already we formed A and A dash, that is 1, 5, 6, 7 minus A dash is 1, 6, 5, 7. So 1 minus 1, 0, 5 minus 6, minus 1, 6 minus 5, 1, 7 minus 7, 0. So this is matrix C. But we have to prove this is skew symmetric. For that, we have to find C transpose. So first row of C becomes first column of C transpose and second row becomes second column. If I take minus 1 outside from C transpose, the matrix becomes 0, here minus 1, here plus 1 and 0. See this matrix, it is same as matrix C. So it becomes minus C. So C transpose is equal to minus C implies C is skew instrumental and skew symmetric matrix. First one. This problem is important for 3 marks. So, given a square matrix, we have to express this matrix as sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. Now, we recall the theorem 2, that is, any square matrix A can be expressed as sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. So, same theorem is applied in this problem. So, first I will consider the given matrix as A, that is 3, 5, 1, minus 1. Now, A can be written as like this, that is half into A plus A dash plus half into A minus A dash. I will take this term as sum P and this as sum Q, where P is a symmetric and Q is a skew symmetric matrix. And you have to prove P is symmetric. That implies you have to prove P dash equal to P. Since Q is skew symmetric, you have to prove Q dash is equal to minus Q. Once you prove P is symmetric and Q is skew symmetric, then you have to verify the condition, that is P plus Q equal to A. Then only we can say that A is expressed as sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. So, same procedure we will do
A transpose
3, 1, 5, minus 1. Now, the difference of two matrices, that is 3 minus 3, 0, 5 minus 1, 4, 1 minus 5, minus 4, minus 1, minus of minus, that is plus, so minus 1 plus 1, 0. Now, half into the matrix, that is scalar multiplication. So, you want to multiply half to each and every element of the matrix, that is 0. 4 into 1 by 2, 2, minus 4 by 2, minus 2, and 0. So, this is matrix Q. Now, we have to check the condition Q transpose. So, first row of Q becomes first column, that is 0, 2. And second row becomes the second column. So, Q transpose is 0, minus 2, 2, 0. Here, you have to take minus outside. So, if I took minus 1 outside, the resultant matrix is 0, 2, minus 2, 0. Now, this matrix is same as matrix Q. So, Q dash equal to minus Q implies Q is skew symmetric. Now, we have to check the condition P plus Q equal to A. Therefore, consider P plus Q. Here P is matrix 3, 3, 3 minus 1, and Q is this, that is 0, 2, minus 2, 0. Now add these two, 3 plus 0, 3, 3 plus 2, 5, 3 plus minus, that is 3 minus 2, 1, minus 1 plus 0, minus 1. Now see, this is same as the given A. So A can be written as P plus Q, where P is symmetric and Q is skew symmetric. Therefore, the given matrix A can be expressed as sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. So this problem is important for 3 marks.
What is P? It is half into matrix
8 plus 8 transpose. So half into matrix A 6 minus 2, 2 minus 2, 3 minus 1, 2 minus 1, 3 plus what is A transpose? 6 minus 2, 2 minus 2, 3 minus 1, 2 minus 1, 3. Now on simplifying, we get 6 plus 6 12 by 2. Again 6 minus 2 plus minus 2 minus 4 divided by 2 minus 2. 2 plus 2 4, 4 by 2, 2. Minus 2 plus minus 2 minus 4 divided by 2 minus 2. 3 plus 3 6 by 2, 3. Minus 1 minus 1 minus 2 divided by 2 minus 1. 2 plus 2 4, 4 by 2, 2. Minus 1 minus 1 minus 2 divided by 2 minus 1. 3 plus 3 6 by 2, 3. So this is matrix P. Now we have to find P transpose. Now we have to find P transpose. That is, the first row is first column. So 6 minus 2, 2. Second row becomes the second column. Minus 2, 3, minus 1. And the third row becomes the third column. So this is P transpose. Now see, both P and P transpose, both are same. Therefore, P is simple. Now we have to find the Q. What is matrix Q? It is half into A minus A transpose. That is half into matrix A 6 minus 2, 2 minus 2, 3 minus 1, 2 minus 1, 3 minus A transpose 6 minus 2, 2 minus 2, 3 minus 1, 2 minus 1, 3. Now since these both are same, the difference is a zero matrix. So half into a zero matrix of order 3 cross 3 means again we will get a zero matrix, that is of order 3 cross 3. So the elements are like this: 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So this is Q. Now we have to verify Q transpose. Since it is a zero matrix, again you will get same. So you can write this as minus Q. Since Q is also zero matrix, if we are multiplying the scalar minus 1, there is no difference. So Q dash is equal to minus Q implies Q is Q symmetric. So once you get P and Q, the last step is you have to add P plus Q. So now, the last step, consider P plus Q. So P is 6 minus 2, 2 minus 2, 3 minus 1, 2 minus 1, 3. And matrix Q is 0 matrix of order 3 cross 3. Now, the resultant matrix is 6 minus 2, 2 minus 2, 3 can be expressed as sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. Now, write some more questions. Two.